The story of the wheats and tares began in the book of Genesis. The serpent just deceived Adam and Eve. Eve said, "The serpent beguiled me." The father turned to the serpent and said,
"But God said unto the woman, What is this that thou hast done? And the woman said, The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, Because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle and above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel." Unto the woman he said, "I will greatly multiply."
The word beguile means to woo, hypnotize, or seduce. So Eve was wooed by the serpent. I truly believe that this resulted in the tares. The father also said that he will call enmity between the man's seed and the seed of the serpent. It is also strange that the serpent was cursed above all cattle and animals. Also, to eat the dust of the earth. Verses later, man is reminded that he is made of the dust of the earth. The serpent was also told that he will go upon his belly. I believe that this means he and his seed, the tares, will live underground. Cain and Abel were soon born afterward. The division between wheat and tares is clear. Abel was a shepherd, keeping with the father's command to care for the animals and the earth. Cain became a tiller of the soil. Abel gave the father his best. Cain gave the father his second best. Also, without blood, there is no remission of sins. And plants don't have blood. Cain was also trying to reach heaven his own way. This was the second open rebellion against God. The nature of Cain's sacrifice is lost to history. I believe that it was the first occult ritual. Cain was banished and walked to the kingdom of Nod. Just like the story of the wheat and tare, the other seed sprouted and mingled with the wheat. There is no way to tell the difference at that point. The roots are completely entangled. One thing is for sure is that we can look at the nature of wheat and tares to help us understand the story. Wheat is in the grass family. It originated in the Levant in the Near East. It is grown on more land than any other food crop. Wheat was key in the formation of city-states. It is a staple food then as it is now. Tares are weeds that resemble wheat when it is very young, commonly called vexes. Tares can uproot wheat as they grow. They are in the pea family also. The harvesters are to collect both the wheat and the tares. The wheat is put into a barn and the tares are gathered and burned. When the wheat is mature, they bow low. Tares stand up tall and proud. No civilization was ever raised on tares. They are not stable enough. Wheat is in the cereal grain group. Many civilizations was supported by either wheat, corn, or rice. The Nicolaitans and other groups blended in with the early church. They quickly spread, much like the weedy habits of the tares, trying to make their own way, just like their father Cain.
bleeding. But I can see how you were fooled. It's not a Coronelli, but it is as damn near as makes no difference.
What do you mean?
The oxidation of the ink. Whoever forged this forged it at least 200 years ago.